Welcome back. In the last video, we looked into the Ladybug Tools Sunhour analysis, direct Sunhour analysis without the weather file, just creating a custom location for your project. This video, we look into the solar radiation study, just to understand the difference, and the difference is quite fundamental. So the Sunhour study measures the direct sunlight, the direct vector from the sun to the surface, and checks if is there sun or no sun. That's all what it does. And it goes through the time period and all the hours of the day, or depending on the time steps. But it checks basically for each time step. It checks for each of the test surfaces or test cells. It checks if there's sunlight or no sunlight. And then it just counts how many hours. So it counts for each of the test cells how many hours were there was sun or there were no sun. And it does not take anything other than that into account. It's really the location and the vector of the sunlight, the angle of the sun. It does not take any skylight into account. It does not take any weather pattern into account, like is it cloudy or is it not cloudy. That's all not in that analysis. The radiation study takes the weather pattern into account, and it also takes the skylight into account. So we will build the radiation study with the latest Ladybug tools. We did that before with the legacy tools, but we haven't done it for the latest Ladybug tools, and that's what we do now. Yeah, we just used the same model as before, and now today we look into the Ladybug incident radiation. And we also look into the real-time incident radiation, so we can see what the difference is. For the direct sun hours, we found out that we don't need to use the weather data. We can actually use a custom location. We can build our custom location, our custom coordinates for our specific project. For the radiation study, it doesn't test hours, it tests the energy hitting the different cells. But for that, we need more than just the location. We need actually the weather pattern, because what it does, it actually, that's basically already built, but we will build it from scratch. So it, instead of like testing each, so what the Sunhour analysis does, it takes the vector of the sunlight and tests if there's a direct connection between the sun and the test cell. It's basically yes or no, it's sunlight or no sunlight. And then it does that for every hour of the test period. The radiation study is different. The radiation study tests the radiation, the energy of the light hitting your object. And for that, it creates first a matrix, a sky matrix, as it is here, and this is like a sky matrix of one day, and it not just tests the sunlight, the direct radiation on your surface, but also the indirect sun, the indirect radiation, meaning the skylight, everything around. So you can actually see that this is basically the path the sun crosses the sky. But then here it was there were more clouds, then there was no cloud, and then it was a bit cloudy again, there was no cloud, and so on. And that was dusk until dusk, from dusk till dawn, dawn till dusk. But also the skylight gives a certain radiation, and we can see that specifically if we have a longer period. We'll look into that right now. So let's kill all these and we start from scratch. And again, I see that as preparing the data, solving the data, output the data visually. And I always start with the solver in Ladybug, because that tells me exactly what I need to input. So let's go here. In Ladybug incident radiation, it says we need the sky matrix, we need the geometry, we need the context. Don't know why the context is, I think this is wrong, but maybe I'm wrong. We actually don't need to input that anyway, we can input it anyway. So sky matrix, geometry, context. We need the grid size, this is the cell size of the resolution of our test basically. In meter, the offset, this is the offset of the mesh which are created to visualize the test. Legend parameters, we don't need to look into that. You can look into that if you want. There's this tool, it's called Ladybug Legend Parameters. You can change the parameters like text size, font style, and so on. And then we need to run. _ means mandatory input underscore in front and the end means mandatory, but there's a default value, and underscore at the end means optional. So first sky matrix, that's what we just saw, it was this dome. Actually, we could look into here, visualize data, Ladybug cumulative sky matrix. That's what we need. And it actually tells you here what you need. A sky matrix on the Ladybug cumulative sky matrix component, which describes the radiation coming from the various patches of the sky. So basically it creates this dome, and from that it will project onto your test surface, and that will calculate for the period. Okay, we can actually put this in here. This runs only with an additional software which is called Radiance. It says actually here, get a matrix containing radiation values from each patch of the sky dome. Creating this matrix is necessary pre-step before doing incident radiation analysis with Rhino geometry or generating radiation rows. Okay, that's could be also interesting sometime to do that. This component uses radiance's gen day matrix function to calculate the radiance for each patch of the sky. More information can be found in radiance manual at blah blah. So we need to have radiance installed. You can install radiance very easily. Just go here on radiance. Let's just search for radiance. This one, radiance red sight, a validated lighting simulation tool. That's actually also needed when you do honeybee calculations. So it's anyway good to install. So we can go here, download and install. We go to Radiance installers. Then it leads us to the GitHub. Of course, you can also look into the source code if you're that smart. Then here we need to click on the latest version, which is this one. At least I use the latest version, and then you can choose here the installer. Actually, I installed it here already. When you downloaded it, you just go here, right click, run as administrator, and just follow the step. Shouldn't be any issue. If you have done that, then you will not get any errors. Otherwise, you will get errors here. In any case, we need the location. We can build our custom location and then use a weather file from the closest weather file we can find, the weather data file we can find. In my case, I'll just choose a location with the weather file. On how to set up a custom location, please check out the previous video. We need this. Well, let's finish these first. Geometry, B-Wrap. Hoppala. All these, okay. I want to test everything, but I also want to use it as the context as well, so I can put it here in here as well. Then we need a grid size. I think 1 meter is fine. Offset distance, it's basically the offset of the surfaces of the newly created mesh surfaces. I can show you later how that looks like. You can specify on how far it offsets. It's good, it's a good thing that it's offset, so you can actually see it if you have geometry overlapping. And we need a toggle again. It's the setup is very similar to the direct sunlight hour study. So that's what we need here. Then we need here, we need the location. Let's choose the location here. We need the diffuse radiation. That's interesting, it has illuminance, the brightness. Okay, again, getting carried off here. Direct normal radiation, diffuse radiation, and then we need a time period. Let's put in here this tool, analyze period. We can put this here, and of course we need the weather file, so let's copy the toggle. Let's go to where you want to go. Anywhere. Here. Click. Okay. Copy. Need a panel. It takes a bit to download. And then if this turns gray, then it's fine. That should all work already. So in the analyze period at the moment, we need to provide something, because here if we disconnect this here. Actually, I'm not sure if it's... I'm not sure if there's anything in there. Maybe there's already a sky matrix in there that you can actually visualize the sky matrix with this tool here. The Ladybug Sky Dome. That will visualize how the cumulative sky matrix actually looks like. Put this here and I connect this. Gives you this. So you can see... So this is basically... for each of these cells, for each of these cells, it creates an average of the year's radiation coming from that position. It also includes the sky radiation, the indirect sky radiation, which you can see here. But it also takes the weather pattern into account. I can show it better when we use only one day. We can actually do that maybe if I... Let's check that later. Because then you understand better what I mean by weather pattern. So it takes into account if there's clouds, no clouds, and so on. Yeah, we just need to, let's hide that here and let's run this. Oh, there's a mistake again. I have a mistake here. If this happens, if you have a surface which is doesn't have any color, then it's basically flipped. Then we would need to do this flip. Now it recalculates everything. Yeah. The incident radiation study is actually very quick, so that's quite nice. If I would now, so actually, what is the output? The output is kilowatt per hours per square meter. So it's actually good that we use one that gives you very good idea how much energy is does this area receive during a whole year, and you can use that information to approximate what you might get out of a solar panel. If you have solar panels, and how much energy you might be able to generate. And there are charts online where you can look it up if it would make sense to actually have solar panels or which area and so on. And then you could even probably see if what kind of angle these solar panels have to be in order to be most productive. Okay, if I quickly go here and put in one, I just put one specific day, because that's, I think it's important to see that. Start month 6. By the way, you can change the color here if you want. So you can create different kind of input types with a color code. Start of the day. Start day is, so today is the 12th. Let's say today, and then the start hour is 6 o'clock in the morning, and let's take this, and the end hour is 8, let's say, and that's my analysis period. So now this is asking for hours of the year, so it doesn't ask for a period, it asks for the hour of the year. So I can put this in here. Oh yeah, it's already there. And then you can see now the kilowatt per hours went down quite a lot because we only testing one day. But now if I look into the Sky Dome, let's turn the Sky Dome on again. And you can see why. Because the sun came up and you can see actually the sun path in that case. But you can see here that actually there was a bit less direct radiation coming. There was actually very little radiation. And that's because this tool takes the weather pattern into account. It actually checks, it takes the information from that file, which gives you the direct and diffuse radiation, meaning that sometimes you have clouds on the sky, and that's why you have less direct radiation, and that's reflected in here. Pretty cool. And another thing is, if you now want to calculate a bit more, if you want to make it a bit more precise, you can actually go here on high density. That will give you a denser output. So if I go in here, put this on true, hopefully it will not crash. No, shouldn't. Creates you a matrix which is much more dense. Anything else? What else? Oh yeah. Let's try the, so this tool here, the Ladybug real-time incident radiation. Yeah, just very quickly to finalize this. I just tried a bit offline basically on how that could work. So let's kill the Sky Dome. We have our current incident radiation for the whole year. That's the whole year. And it says here the real-time Ladybug real-time incident radiation. Commute incident radiation values for any sky matrix in real time using the geometry sky intersection matrix produced by the Ladybug incident radiation component. Let's using the component enables one to scroll through radiation on an hour by hour or month by month basis in a manner that is an order of magnitude faster than running each sky matrix through the Ladybug incident radiation component. The speed of this component is thanks to the fact that geometry sky intersection matrix contains a relationship between geometry and each patch of the sky. So computing new radiation values is as simple as multiplying the sky matrix by the intersection matrix. So I'm not 100% clear if I'm doing this correctly because it's not further described. Because the problem is, so this is the thing. The problem is there are two inputs, but there's no way to scroll through. So what I'm understanding now, this is the geometry sky intersection matrix from the Ladybug incidence radiation component. This matrix contains the relationship between each point of the analyzed geometry. Okay, so we get this thing here. And then in order to scroll through, we actually need a sky matrix where we can scroll through separately from the one we're already using. Because that doesn't work. Like if I scroll through here, it always recalculates everything. But if I think what I need to do, I need to make a copy of the sky matrix and have basically this hour of the day tool where I can scroll through month, day, hour and get this into, and the result need to go into a heat map. So instead of using this tool here, we actually need the Ladybug special heat map. The result goes into values. And the mesh will take the mesh from the original incident radiation. That's how it's described here. A list of numbers to align with the points of the original analysis performed with the Ladybug incident radiation component. So I can only understand it like this, that basically you can, if I turn this off now I can actually scroll through hour by hour by hour. Yeah, that actually works pretty good. But I don't want to tell something wrong. I think I still need to explore it a bit more in depth because I would also like to get the output correctly. Because at the moment it just gives me a number, but what does that number mean? I'm not sure. So it's not well described. So maybe I can find a better description and then we can look at that another time. But yeah, that's the radiation analysis with the newest Ladybug tools.